गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। ॐ सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्वेताश्वतरोपनिषद अध्याय 2 मंत्र 15। यदात्मतत्त्वेन तु ब्रह्मतत्त्वम् दीपोपमेनेहयुक्तः प्रपश्येत् अजं ध्रुवं सर्वतत्त्वैर्विशुद्धम् ज्ञात्वा देवं मुच्यते सर्वपाशैः। श्वेताश्वतरोपनिषद रिपीटेडली मेक्स वन स्टेटमेंट, देर इज नो मोक्ष विदाउट ज्ञान। ज्ञान इज द ओनली वे टू मोक्ष। This idea is very much emphasized in Shvetashvatara Upanishad. Even in the previous verse you might have seen, Tadvatma tattvam prasamikshya dehi ekah kritartho bhavate vita shokaha. Atma tattvam prasamikshya. Having understood the Atma tattva, kritartho bhavate. One becomes a kritartha, means he gets moksha. And in this verse also, the Upanishad makes the same proclamation. Jnana is the way to moksha. See, last line, ज्ञात्वा देवं मुच्यते सर्वपाशैः। ओनली बाय नोइंग देव, ओनली बाय नोइंग द आत्मा, द परमात्मा, वन बिकम्स फ्री, फ्री फ्रॉम संसार। ज्ञान इज द ओनली वे टू मोक्ष। Vedanta is very clear about it. No chance of any doubt. Is there any other way than jnana to get moksha? No chance. And it is very much so logically. If ajnana is the cause of samsara, the way to moksha has to be jnana alone, because ajnana cannot be removed by any means other than jnana. But then, if jnana is the only way to moksha, why everyone cannot seek only jnana? Why there are other sadhanas? The Shastra gives so many other sadhanas also. Karma Yoga is also prescribed in the Shastra. Bhakti is also prescribed in the Shastra. In fact, this is the question asked by Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna asks Krishna in chapter 3 of Bhagavad Gita, Jayasi Chet Karmanaste Mata Buddhir Janardana Tatkim Karmani Ghore Mam Niyo Jayasi Keshava. O Krishna, O Janardana, if jnana is greater than karma, then why do you ask me to do karma? And not just any karma, it is a ghora karma. As far as Arjuna is concerned, his karma is ghora karma because it involves violence. It involves fighting, shooting. Why are you making me do karma? Then Krishna shows the importance of karma yoga. Without karma, one cannot arrive at jnana. Because in order to prepare oneself for jnana, karma is needed. Nowadays, jnana is appealing to many people. They read some books casually. And then jnana is quite appealing to them. They get attracted to jnana. Aham Brahmasmi. They want to get jnana. But unfortunately, majority of the seekers of jnana lack in preparation. That is why many people come and complain, Swamiji, I understand everything, but I cannot abide in it. The main problem is Vairagya. Without Vairagya, it is not possible to get jnana. But it is not easy to get Vairagya. If I want to get jnana without vairagya, it is not going to happen. I want to hold on to my body. I want to hold on to my present identity. I want to hold on to all my possessions, all my relations. Then I want to get atma jnana. It is never going to happen. Jnana is possible only when there is intense vairagya, tivra vairagya, prabala vairagya. Therefore, to get jnana, one should make effort to cultivate vairagya. How to cultivate vairagya? It cannot be forced. I cannot dictate you vairagya. From this day onwards, none of you should have any desire. From this day onwards, you should not have any attachment to your children or grandchildren. It cannot be forced. Vairagya is a result of spiritual maturity. It is a result of spiritual maturity. You can observe the coconut tree. The coconut fruit, how it is tightly fixed to the tree when it is raw, and as the fruit ripens, as the coconut ripens, slowly it starts detaching, and one day it falls down by itself. What makes it fall down? It is maturity. It is ripening. It is paripakvata. In Sanskrit, ripening is called becoming paripakva. When the fruit becomes paripakva, it detaches from the tree. Likewise, the vairagya has to come as a result of spiritual maturity. How to accomplish spiritual maturity? That is why we need all other sadhanas. And at the center of all other sadhanas, there is a bhakti. In Bhagavata Mahatmya, bhakti is the mother of jnana and vairagya. There is a beautiful story. Narada went to Vrindavan on the bank of Yamuna, and there he finds an old lady, not old lady, a lady. She is not old at that time. She has become a little younger look, healthy look she got. But she has two children, and the children were looking old, you know, aged, and they were unconscious, lying down. Then Narada asked this lady, "Who are you? And who are these two? Then the lady says, I am Bhakti. She is a Bhakti. And the two children are Jnana and Vairagya. They are my sons. They are the sons of Bhakti. That is how Bhagavata Mahatmya begins. And then the story follows. Narada finds a way to, you know, bring them back to good health. And that is how he discovers a solution. And the solution is to listen to Bhagavata Katha. That is how the story is. But what I have to point out is, Bhakti is the mother of Jnana and Vairagya. Bhakti gives rise to Vairagya. And then Jnana. Bhaktif Pareshanu Bhavo Viraktihi. Bhagavata itself says this. Bhakti. And Bhakti is followed by Virakti, Vairagya. And Bhakti and Vairagya are followed by Pareshanubhava, Paramatma Anubhava, Paramatma Jnana. And the Jnana is Aparoksha Jnana. It is not Paroksha Jnana. There are two types of Jnana. One is Paroksha Jnana, another is Aparoksha Jnana. What is Paroksha Jnana? If you say something is somewhere, then it is Paroksha Jnana. You have just heard about it. And you know it is there because somebody told you. Then it is Paroksha Jnana. In America there is somebody, some gentleman is living in America. The president of America. He is staying in Washington. We have heard there is a president of America. It is Paroksha Jnana. We have just heard, and nowadays we might have seen the image. But still it is Paroksha. But when you directly see the person, then it is Aparoksha. Aparoksha Jnana. The Jnana that is prescribed in the Vedanta, the Jnana which leads to Moksha, it is not Paroksha Jnana. It is Aparoksha Jnana. Paroksha Jnana cannot give Moksha. Paroksha Jnana is okay to begin with. Initially the Jnana happens as Paroksha Jnana only. That is what Kathopanishad says. Asti tevo palabdhavyaha tattva bhavena chobhayoho. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಸ್ತೀತ್ಯೇವೋಪಲಬ್ಧವ್ಯ. ಒನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಅಸ್ತಿ. ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಅಸ್ತಿ, ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಅಸ್ತಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಪರೋಕ್ಷ ಜ್ಞಾನ. ಬಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ಅಪರೋಕ್ಷ ಜ್ಞಾನ. ಅಸ್ತೀತ್ಯೇವೋಪಲಬ್ಧಸ್ಯ ತತ್ವಜ್ಞ ತತ್ವಭಾವ ಪ್ರಸೀದತಿ. ಅಸ್ತೀತ್ಯೇವೋಪಲಬ್ಧಸ್ಯ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಸ್ತಿ, ಯು ನೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್, ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಪರೋಕ್ಷ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್. That is why initially paroksha jnana is needed. To begin with we need paroksha jnana. And paroksha jnana is in the form of a shraddha, is in the form of a faith. There is Brahman. You may not have seen Brahman. But still you have heard from the Shastra. The Shastra says there is Brahman, therefore there is Brahman. This is Paroksha Jnana. And with the Paroksha Jnana you pursue, I should get a Paroksha Jnana. Now the problem is it is even difficult to get paroksha jnana because people don't have shraddha in the shastra. Without having shraddha, even paroksha jnana does not happen. And without paroksha jnana, aparoksha jnana is not possible. In fact, they want first aparoksha jnana. Then they will get shraddha. It is not going to happen. It is like a child, the modern child, a smart child. With a smartphone, everyone is smart. A smart child is asking its mother. The mother is teaching the child A, B, C, D. You have to learn A, B, C, D. Then this child asks, why I should learn A, B, C, D? Then the mother says, so that you can become educated. After getting education, you may become a doctor or an engineer. You will become like your father. You will become like your mother. You will go to office. You will buy a car. That is how you tell the child. But then the child asks, what is the guarantee that I will become a doctor or engineer? If I learn A, B, C, D. First you prove me. First you show me that I will become a doctor. Then I will start learning A, B, C, D. Will it ever work? That is why the role of Shraddha, the role of trust, is very important. Without trust, in our well-wisher, we cannot grow. The child cannot grow without trust. It has to trust its mother, its father, its well-wishers. So, first, one should have Shraddha in the words or the Shastra. As Shankaracharya says, the Shastra is 100 times greater well-wisher than mother, greater well-wisher than thousands of mother and father put together. Matra Pitra Sahasrebhya Api Hitaishi Vedaha. The Veda is 1000 times greater well-wisher than our mother and father. Therefore, it is necessary to have Shraddha in the Vedas. It is necessary to have Shraddha in the Shastra. And then there is Paroksha Jnana. And in due course of time, with the Bhakti, with the Vairagya, there is Aparoksha Jnana. So the Upanishad is once again proclaiming that the Aparoksha Jnana is the way to moksha. Yada Atma Tattvena Tu Brahma Tattvam Deepopameneha Yuktav Prapashyet. Yada, at which time of spiritual maturity, during Aparoksha Jnana, Atma Tattvena, there is a description of Atma Tattva, Deepopamena Atma Tattvena. The Atma Tattva is like light. It is effulgent like Deepa. Effulgent like a lamp. Means Swayam Prakashah Ityarthah. It is Swayam Prakasha. It is self-effulgent. And iha, there is iha, deepopamena iha, the Atma Tattva is iha. Iha means here, in this body. Iha deepopamena, Atma Tattvena, the Atma Tattva. Atma is a tattva. Atma is the reality. There are other tattvas according to other philosophers. According to Sankhya philosophy, there are 25 tattvas. Means 25 types of realities are there. Each one is a tattva for them. But the Vedanta says only one tattva, only one reality, that is Atma. Atma is a tattva, and if it is anatma, non-self, it is atatva, it is not tatva, it is atatva. Anything other than atma is atatva, unreal. Brahma tattvam, this atma tattva is brahma tattva. It is brahat, brahatvat brahma. It is all pervasive, brahma tattva. And the brahma tattva is described ajam. It is free from birth, no birth, no beginning. Brahman is aja, because no beginning. See, the Jagat Karanam, the cause of the universe, cannot have a beginning. If the cause has a beginning, then you will have to find another cause. The ultimate cause. The ultimate cause cannot have a beginning. If the ultimate cause has a beginning, it cannot be the ultimate cause, because it will need another cause. Therefore, Brahman cannot have a beginning. Anadi, aja, aja means anadi. Likewise, this atma, see, Jagat Karana cannot have a beginning. We cannot have a beginning as well. We means Atma. The Atma cannot have a beginning as well. Why the Atma cannot have a beginning? Because if Atma has a beginning, there will be a logical fallacy called akritabhyagama dosha. Akritabhyagama dosha. I got this birth. If I have to take this birth, I need a karma. Without karma, janma is not possible. If I have to get a body, body requires karma. If birth itself, this janma itself, is the beginning of me, beginning of my atma, then where did the karma come? The karma responsible for present birth, where has it come from? Without any cause, a birth is not possible. Without any karma, birth is not possible. It is called akritabhyagama dosha. In other words, I am getting the result of a karma which is not done before. If I have got a janma, if I have got a birth without a karma prior to this birth, that means I am getting the result of karma that I have not done before. It is called akritabhyagama dosha. So, accepting the birth of Atma will lead to a logical fallacy called Akritabhyagama Dosha. Therefore, we have to accept that Atma has no beginning. Atma is Ajaha, free from birth. So Atma is Aja and Brahman is Aja. Brahman has no beginning. Therefore, Atma is Brahman. This is one logic that shows the oneness of Atma and Brahman. So, Ajam, then Dhruvam, Dhruvam. The Bhashyakara says, Aprachyuta Swarupam. The Brahman does not have Swarupa Prachyuti. Swarupa Prachyuti means losing one's Swarupa, losing one's nature. Any distortion in one's nature. If you look at our body, it loses its swarupa. Our childhood photo and the present photo. If you look at both the photos, there is a lot of difference. Then it was a cute little baby. Now it is all distorted, worn out. Hair has turned grey. Teeth has fallen. Everything has happened. So there is a swarupa prachyuti as far as this body is concerned. It will lose its swarupa and finally it will degenerate, disintegrate. That is this body. But the Atma does not lose its nature. Free from all changes, free from all modifications. That is Dhruvam. That is why Paramatma is called Achyutaha, free from Chyuti, free from downfall. Sarva Tattvair Vishuddham. Sarva Tattvaihi Vishuddham. Absolutely pure. Avidya Tatkaryaihi Asamsrishtam Ityarthaha. Not affected by Avidya and its effects. Avidya does not touch the Atma. And its effects, the effects of avidya, even they do not affect the Atma. Yuktav prapashyet. One knows this Atma Tattva. Yuktaha, with the focus. Being a yogi, one knows the Atma Tattva. Tada, then Devam Jnata Sarva Papair Muchyate. Having understood the Deva, having understood the Paramatma, he becomes free from all Pasha. He becomes free from all bondage. He becomes free from samsara. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harih Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harih Om.